Hello everyone. So far we have had discussions on rapidly varied flow under the non-uniform flow. In this segment we shall have the gradually varied flow. Gradually varied flow is one in which the depth changes gradually over a long distance. Gradually varied flow may be caused due to one or more of the following factors, such as the change in the shape and size of the channel cross section, the change in slope of the channel, the presence of obstruction such as wear dam, and the change in frictional forces at the boundaries. We also consider some assumptions whenever we go for the analysis part of gradually varied flow. Those assumptions are the channel is prismatic, the bed slope is small, the flow is steady and hence discharge is constant, the pressure distribution over the channel section is hydrostatic, that is streamlines are practically straight and parallel, the Chagee and Manning correlations are equally applicable to gradually varied flow for determining the slope of energy line. So if I consider an example of a dam, on the upstream side some amount of water is stored and on the downstream side water rushes out from a spillway. So any water which is flowing in a natural stream directly comes under a open channel flow case. We have a hydraulic jump on the downstream side of this dam somewhere here. Probably here you can imagine there is a YC or critical flow condition, and water which is stored, ideally which is stored, realistically it also has some amount of flow, is characterized under gradually varied flow. Now if you just compare the scenario of this dam and that of this sketch, upstream side and downstream side. Now on the downstream side you have rapidly varied flow, and the classical example what we have discussed so far under rapidly varied flow is the hydraulic jump. Now we shall look into some more theories, equations under gradually varied flow. So if you just consider a longitudinal section of a channel which probably falls under a upstream side of a dam, you can identify B as width of the channel, and let's say there is a discharge, constant discharge Q is flowing, and Z as the height of bottom or so called the datum, Y is depth of flow, and V is the mean velocity, V square by 2G is the kinetic head, and there are I and J in addition to the other things. I is the slope of the channel bed, and J is slope of energy line. So we approximate here I or tan I being equals to I as SB. SB is slope of the channel bed, S subscript B. And there is one more thing which is known as SE. E is for energy line, S subscript E is tan of J, or it is also equals to J. So we shall try to identify an equation for gradually varied flow. Now there are two directions which we consider here. One is X along the flow and the other one is Y across the flow or in the vertical direction. So if at all I need to write an equation for the energy, I have only one option, that is E equals to Z plus Y plus V square by 2G, the classical Bernoulli's equation. Now what I'll do is, I just identify the variation of energy in x-axis. So the variation of energy in x-axis is dE by dx. You differentiate the earlier equation with respect to x. So the terms you will get, differentiation of z with respect to x is dz by dx plus dy by dx plus d by dx of v square by 2g. Now v square by 2g can be substituted with some more values. Now, the meaning of d by dx of v square by 2g has other variables which comes into picture now. So V is Q by A, the classical continuity equation, or A is B into Y. Okay, so d by dx of v square by 2g gets some more meanings, like d by dx of, see, v can be substituted with q by a, q by a square by 2g, and a is b into y, so there is one y term, so it becomes square, y square. So ultimately d by dx of v square by 2g can be written in terms of q square by b square into 2g, the constant values, into d by dx of 1 by y square. Now differentiation of d by dx of 1 by y square is the next step. So you can see here, it's q square by b square into 2g into differentiation of d by dx of 1 by y square, or it is differentiation of y to the power minus 2 is minus 2 into y to the power minus 3. So y to the power minus 3 is 1 by y to the power 3, and that is what we just written here, into dy by dx. Okay, now we have the term called minus 2 q square by b square 2gy cube into dy by dx. We are considering a substitution for d by dx of v square by 2g, and we have the substitution for d by dx of v square by 2g as minus v square by gy into dy by dx. Okay, so we'll substitute this to the basic equation, the second equation. So you have dE by dx equals to dz by dx plus dy by dx minus v square by gy into dy by dx. See, we all know that v by square root of gy is Froude's number, and Froude's number square is v square by gy. So in the next steps, we'll substitute v square by gy as Froude's number square. Okay, now I'll club the terms which have dy by dx. So you have dy by dx, dy by dx, you can take this out as a common thing. So dE by dx equals to dz by dx plus dy by dx into 1 minus v square by gy. Now the meaning of dE by dx, dE, E is this line. dE by dx is change in the values of E with respect to the values of x. So dE by dx as if it's a slope, and it accounts energy. So you can directly write this dE by dx as slope of the energy line, and the slope decreases. So it has a negative sign. So it is minus SE. The next one is dz by dx. So z is the datum, the distance from the datum to the bottom of the channel. dz by dx is one more slope, which also has a negative sign by the virtue of the reduction in the values of slope. So the value of dz by dx is minus sb. So why it is se and sb? It always determined by the values of numerator here, dE by dx, E. So it is energy line, Z. So for the Z line or bottom of the channel, you have a slope of I. So it is minus SB. So I'll substitute dE by dx and dz by dx in terms of minus SE and minus SB. That is what we have here. Minus SE equals to minus SB plus dy by dx into 1 minus V square by gy. Or dy by dx equals to sb minus sc divided by 1 minus v square by gy, or dy by dx equals to sb minus sc divided by 1 minus Froude's number square. Now this is an equation for gradually varied flow. The meaning of this equation, dy by dx, it says something related to dy by dx. Dy by dx is change in the depth of flow along x direction. So it will directly give you the profile of change in the depth along x direction as sb minus se divided by 1 minus Froude's number square. Now the question is, how do you calculate se? Anyhow, sb is given in the problem statement itself, or you can measure from the field. SE is always calculated by using a term in Manning's or Chegg's formula, where we consider the mean or average depth of flow. So you have a term called slope in Manning's formula as well as in the Chegg's formula. You revert it, you just calculate the value of slope for a given constant depth of flow of discharge.